Is it over here? Is it... Oh my gosh, I've really created quite the mess. well, it's... someone else is gonna have to take care of that. I've gotta find my thing. Where did I put my thing? Is it over here? I don't know. What on earth? Hey, Kingsley, are you... Hi. Looks like today on Danny Joe's Treehouse, we're gonna talk about taking responsibility and cleaning up our messes. We're also gonna read this book. Meet you up there. Can you come out and play? Won't you come out and play? It's a really great day. There's so much to see and so much to do. Nature's calling you. From the blades of the grass to the leaves of the trees, everything's calling you, pretty please. Come and discover, look and uncover what's under every rock. Can you come out and play? Won't you come out and play? It's a really great day. There's so much to see and so much to do. Nature's calling you. From the time you were a baby till the time you grow old, each step you take will help you learn and grow. By asking lots of questions and finding different answers, best way to learn is play. So can you come out and play? It's a really great day, and nature is calling you. Hiya, kiddo. Look at this mess. There's dirty clothes everywhere. Hey. This is so frustrating. Do you know that word? Frustrating. It means upsetting or annoying, or you keep trying to do something right, but it keeps going wrong, or you can't seem to fix it. I try really hard to keep the treehouse neat and tidy. Cleaning up messes is a big responsibility. Do you know that word? Responsibility. It means making good choices. It means even though something is hard to do, it can feel good inside when you do your work. You can be responsible for your own stuff. And as a member of our shared places, like our treehouse and school and library, it can feel good to take responsibility with others. Yeah. When we take responsibility together, it just makes things nicer. When no one takes responsibility, it just makes a bigger mess. If we all work together, it'll make things better. Danny Joe! Danny Joe! Danny Joe! Danny Joe! Where is he? Danny Joe! Have you seen Danny Joe? What? Ugh. What are you doing in here? This is no time to play peek-a-boo. Kingsley, I'm not playing peek-a-boo. Someone threw this on my head and covered me up. I hope that they take responsibility.
Oh, well, I haven't the time to fix your problems. I have my own issues to contend with, don't you know?
Kingsley, is this your mess? Did you throw these clothes all over the place?
How dare you interrogate me? I am your king. Now, where's the shovel? I can't find one anywhere in this mess.
A shovel? What shovel?
The cute little shovel we use at the beach with my royal pail to make sandcastles.
Oh, well, I don't know, Kingsley. It's gonna be hard to find anything in this mess.
Oh, woe is me.
Woe is you, huh?
Yeah, me.
Okay, look, Kingsley, I think we can help you to find your yellow shovel, but first, you are going to have to take responsibility for your mess and clean it up.
What now? I'm not familiar with that word.
Responsibility. It means doing the work to take care of yourself and others, even if it's hard. It's about making good choices for yourself and our shared community. When I think of responsibility, I think of things like taking care of a pet, or cleaning up after yourself after you've made a mess, or just saying you're sorry if you've made a bad choice and trying again.
How dare you accuse me of making this mess? It could be anyone's mess.
This is your cape.
Lots of people wear capes. They're very fashionable. Wait a minute. I spy with my little eye something yellow. Yes, yes, I found it. Hello, little yellow shovel. I've been looking for you. I've got a lot of work to do.
Oh, do you mean you're going to take responsibility and clean up this mess?
What? No, I'm going to dig a hole. Out of my way. Ugh. You know, someone really needs to clean up this mess. It's called responsibility, people.
Kingsley, I know you made this mess. Oh, that little king makes me feel so upset sometimes. I need to calm down and take some breaths. Breathing can help me to calm down when I start to feel frustrated. Going for a walk can help too, or finding a quiet place to read a book. Book. I forgot I brought a book I wanted to read you. It's in the high bucket. Hi. It's a very special book. I made it with my friend Eric. He drew the pictures and I wrote the words. It's all about our friends here at Danny Joe's Treehouse. And just by looking at the cover of the book, what do you think it's about? What do you think's on the inside? You can make a guess, but the only way we really know is by opening up and getting to the words and the pictures inside. These words say, "I like you more than my phone." Written by Danny Joe Lebrecq. That's me. Illustrated by Eric Scales. Means Eric drew the pictures. Let's see what's inside. What do you see? There's the high bucket. And that's me as a cartoon. There's the tree. And there's Teddy. There's our friend Makita making a video of Teddy. See the hearts and the happy faces? It looks like the friends on the other side of the screen are sending messages of love. The words say, "Hiya, kiddo. Welcome to Danny Joe's Treehouse. Today, we're talking about phones. Phones can be fun, and they come in handy sometimes. But they are just tools that we use." Phones don't have thoughts and ideas the way that you do. And they can't feel the way that we do.
Hold it! I have not approved this book!
Kingsley, please don't cover up my book. I was reading it to our friends.
Well, I don't like this book. It makes me look like the bad guy.
What are you talking about, Kingsley? It's about how people are more important than our phones.
Well, that's okay, but look at me in this book. I remember this day, I asked Pixie Belle to make me a flying machine so I could fly up in the sky with all the other birdies.
Yes, I remember that day too.
Yes, well, that was before I learned to be a good guy. This shows how I was ignoring Pixie and looking at me. I'm very handsome, of course, but I didn't want people to remember how I wasn't being nice to Pixie. And I don't want others to know that I wasn't nice at all. I'm a good guy. I'm a good guy.
Oh, I hear you, Kingsley. I do. But, you know, people are more than just good or bad. We have many different feelings. And we can choose how to let our feelings out in ways that don't hurt ourselves and don't hurt anyone else. And sometimes we're going to make mistakes, but we can try again. We can learn from our mistakes. You know, Kingsley, you've come a long way. I see how you're trying to be a better friend to Pixie Belle now.
Then why are you reminding everyone of when I wasn't a good friend?
Well, because that's just part of our story, Kingsley. It's good to remember the lessons we've learned, and it can help others to make good choices too. But really, Kingsley, this is just one page from this book. There's much more to it, and books are for reading, not for hiding.
Well, I
don't know. I'll allow it for now, but, you know, I need some ribbon.
Ribbon?
Yes, yes. Yeah, a big roll of red ribbon. You know, the kind that we use to wrap up presents with.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm not sure if we can find it in this mess, Kingsley. I think you need to take responsibility and clean up.
Wait. I spy, with my little eye, something red. Here it is. Hello, little ribbon. You're coming with me.
I wonder what he's going to do with that yellow shovel and red ribbon. Let's just keep reading. Now, what do you see? I spy so many friends in our shared community playing together outside. What do you see? It says, we decide how to share our thoughts, ideas, and feelings with one another. There can be many different ways.
Hold it! Hold it! Hold it! Stop reading this book! I forbid it!
Now what, Kingsley?
Well, this picture is from when we had our tea party and Pixie Belle baked cookies for everyone. But I wanted all the cookies. I was greedy that day, and I made my friends upset. And I don't like remembering when I make mistakes. I don't want to be seen as the bad guy. I'm a good guy.
Kingsley, come here. You are so much more than just good or bad. People and puppets are complex. We have many different feelings. And learning how to share those feelings in ways that don't hurt ourselves or anyone else takes practice. And again, it's good to learn from our mistakes and try again.
Well, easy for you to say. I don't see you being bad in this book. I feel embarrassed.
Oh, I hear you, Kingsley. But I make mistakes too. I do. I'm a person. I'm not just good or bad. I have lots of different feelings, and sometimes I don't always let them out in kind ways. But I need to learn from my mistakes, just like everybody else. And it can feel good to take responsibility for your actions.
Or, hear me out, you could give me the book and we could wrap it up with this red ribbon.
I don't understand. You want to wrap it up and give it to someone as a present?
No. I was thinking that we could tie it up real tight with this red ribbon, and then we could put it down deep in the hole I just dug up with my yellow shovel, and then we could cover it up so that no one could ever read it again, and we can pretend that we never make bad choices.
Oh, no, Kingsley, no. Books are for reading. They're not for hiding away from others. Books are for all of us. I will not let you or anyone else take away our books. Instead, let's finish our story together. Okay?
Okay, I'll try.
Good, Kingsley. I'm proud of you. Let's turn the page and see what happens next. I really like your thoughts. I really like your ideas. I really like your feelings. I like you more than my phone. We like our phones, but we love you. What do you see, Kingsley?
Well, I spy with my little eye all of the people and the puppets together, and you're holding up your phone. And what does that say on your phone?
It says, add your photo here. I thought our friend could be in the story too.
I like that.
Thank you. Me too.
Aren't you going to say it?
Say what?
Say the end.
Oh, well, it's the end of the book, but it's just the beginning of our story.
What story?
The story of you and me taking responsibility for this mess.
Couldn't we just ignore it and let someone else take care of it instead?
No, not anymore. I spy with my little eye, two eyes and a nose. And I spy with my little eye, your fingers and your toes. and there's something else that's deep inside that I can't quite yet see. But I'll try, you try, together you and me. I spy with my little eye your hair and your clothes, and I spy with my little eye the freckles on your nose. And there's something else that's deep inside that I can't quite yet see. But I'll try, and you try, together you and me. Take some time to discover all the gifts you have inside. Take some time to realize you got nothing to hide. I spy with my little eye. Be proud of who you are. Be who you're meant to be.
It's still messy. It's gonna take more work.
Yes, it is.
Oh, it's frustrating. May I take a break and read your book instead? I promise I'll take good care of it.
You may, but first we have to finish cleaning up this mess.
Okay, I'm very responsible now. Yes. Mm-hmm.
It can be hard to take responsibility for our actions, but when we try, it can feel really good inside. Are you a responsible person? I'm feeling hopeful for tomorrow. Do you know why? Because I know you're going to be there. It's not goodbye. It's just see you later, alligator. After a while, crocodile. It's not the end, my dear friend. I'm glad I got to spend this time with you. It's not goodbye. It's just see you later, gator. After a while, after a while, after a while. Crocodile. See you later. Good luck, Kingsley. You missed a spot.
I know.